Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today I have another magnificent leader and guest for you, but before I go ahead, make sure you subscribe to the channel and share with your communities in healthcare. And let me also acknowledge our series partners and sponsors. We have the series partner for this month, VMware. They're doing great work in healthcare. Make sure you check them out. And also our global partner, Spirit Digital. But without further ado, I'm extremely excited to introduce to you Dr. David Rhew, which is the Global Chief Medical Officer and VP of Healthcare at Microsoft. David, how are you?
Doing great. Great to see you and super excited to be here, Ja.
Fantastic. David, nice to connect again. I have some really nice questions for you. Thank you for taking the time. I know you are busy and you're doing great work. I've been following your great stuff for quite some time. So very grateful to have you here.
Thank you.
We go straight to the questions, David. Is that okay?
Oh, please.
Yeah. So the first question that I have for you is, what are the major trends and opportunities in digital health right now?
Well, I think one of the things we see every day in the news, and certainly things that we have been top of mind for quite some time, is the fact that we have huge disparities of care. This has given us a renewed energy to try to address some of those issues. And one of the things that we are now looking at are ways that digital tools can be used to better engage and allow us to be able to understand how to communicate and coordinate care, specifically as we move outside of the hospital into the communities. And this is going to require us to think of a different model of care. No longer it's about having people come into hospitals and clinics, but it's about empowering the individuals who are working with those in the field to be able to have the tools and the information necessary to be able to deliver better care.
Yeah, brilliant. So digital tools, very, very important. They've been very important, as you know, for quite some time, but now more than ever is really the time to establish these solutions for the patients, for the clinicians, and for everyone else. Thank you for that, David. Moving on to the second question is, can you develop and share some more insight, for example, on virtual healthcare or even on artificial intelligence, which is so well spoken in these days in healthcare, please?
Well, one of the things that we oftentimes find is that there's a lot of excitement and energy around artificial intelligence and machine learning, but also I'd say some misunderstandings. Sometimes people think that this is something that is going to take over the industry and all of a sudden doctors and other healthcare professionals will not find a need. Well, the reality is these are tools that are meant to augment and allow us to be able to become much more efficient and effective. And that is something that we desperately need. Our level of inefficiency in the system, the amount of documentation that we have to do into EHRs, the amount of decision-making that needs to occur, has to be facilitated through technology. And so one of the areas that we have been focusing on at Microsoft are how can we address these through artificial intelligence and simple tools? You know, so for example, a chatbot. A chatbot is an artificial intelligence-based tool based on algorithms and other types of processes that can be incorporated. But it gives us the right information at the right time in settings that allow us to be able to provide to consumers, patients, and even healthcare providers. And the ability for us to be able to provide that information at scale to a large number of individuals was facilitated through a chatbot. It was available on websites such as cdc.gov, hospital health sites, a lot of retailers. They all were leveraging this same type of technology. And allowing us also not just to answer the questions, but triage individuals to the appropriate place.
Yeah, sure. David, you are so right there. That is a lot of hype around artificial intelligence. And I don't know who invented the phrase, but I'm sure you heard it before. Artificial intelligence will not replace the doctor, but those who are not using artificial intelligence will be replaced. So
right.
Thank you so much for that insight. And I know you're doing magnificent work. The third and last question, David, is what do you think will be the most impactful technology or innovation in healthcare and why?
Well, leading off the last question, I do think artificial intelligence has the greatest potential to transform care. And largely because what we are doing is we're leveraging the fact that we have so much information and we can now determine not only what needs to be done now, but how to prevent bad things from happening, being much more proactive. If we think about what the biggest challenge in healthcare is, it's the fact that it's just too expensive. It's very difficult for us to be able to afford care. And what we need to do is we need to figure out ways to be able to remove waste from the system, to be able to be more proactive, identify individuals that are heading in the wrong direction and intervene earlier. So avoiding those expensive hospitalizations, avoiding those expensive complications, and that can only be done when we gather more information, further validate it, and then intervene early. So I see AI as a huge, huge opportunity for us to be able to have direct impact on care, but there's a journey. We have to move along the path of validating it and continue to ensure that these tools are useful in the process. So while we have this broader vision of where AI can play, I think the immediate opportunities are to start leveraging ways that we help better coordinate care and allow us to become much more efficient as healthcare team members. And in that process, we'll start realizing some immediate benefits of tech.
Mm. David, you are so right there that artificial intelligence can be streamlined in different ways, not just to reduce cost, but with accessibility, streamline the data, which we have so much data in these days. So yeah, truly amazing. We could spend an hour perhaps just exploring the third and last question. But David, I appreciate your time. I mentioned before, we come to the end of the show. If is there anything else that you want to mention, please do so. But I finish all my episodes in a peculiar way, which is not a question as such, but it's called 1 minute of fame. Okay. So you can mention anything, personal achievement, professional achievements. You have so many. Family stuff, shout out to a friend, to colleagues, to your great company, anything whatsoever. So to round up, 1 minute of fame, over to you.
Well, one thing I would like to be able to share is an effort that I've been very privileged to be a part of. It's an effort to try to address one of the biggest issues we have today about improving vaccination rates across the country and the globe. We know vaccine hesitancy remains a continued problem. But through public-private partnerships, community-level efforts, we've been able to demonstrate that we can change the mindset and allow individuals to be able to get vaccinated. Microsoft, in collaboration with many of its partners, have launched the Vaccination Equity Initiative, VEI. And as part of that VEI, we are moving at a very important pace to be able to try to enable communities to be able to have the ability to not only get people vaccinated, but also to be able to prevent some of those complications that we're seeing with the fact that hospitals are getting overloaded, ICU beds are getting filled up. You know, if we don't intervene earlier and we don't intervene now in these communities, we will see the consequences that we've seen in other parts of the world. And so for me, this is a very personal initiative. I'm an infectious disease doc, trained in public health. I'm very passionate about this topic, but I see the need for public-private partnerships and organizations to lean in specifically on this issue.
Fantastic. David, thank you so much. As I mentioned to you before the recording, I'm in Portugal, and the efforts around the vaccination have been tremendous around the globe. But, you know, I'm based in UK. Over 70% of the population has been vaccinated. But also in here in Portugal, now is narrowed down to the younger people, to the younger generations. And what you share is extremely powerful and also very impactful, because I mean, we protect others by being vaccinated and everything. So thank you so much for sharing that great work and your initiative, and also the partnerships in terms of working together with your collaborative approach. Thank you so much for that.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Brilliant, David. I'm going to round up. Nice to see you, and thank you so much for your expertise, your insights, and your time.
It's been a pleasure, and looking forward to the next conversation.
Brilliant, David. Thank you so much. And now I'm going to round up. Thank you to our viewers and listeners. Make sure you subscribe also connect with Dr. David Rhew. I'm going to post here his Twitter and also his LinkedIn, ask about the great efforts and work at Microsoft, and also acknowledge our sponsors and partners, VMware, our series partner, and Spirit Digital, our global partner. And I'll see you all next time.